Stormborn has a question. Before enrolling here, my only experience with a programming language was a bit of JavaScript. In JavaScript, there are a lot of brackets and semicolons to mark the end of statements, but there seems to be none of that in Python. I was just wondering how Python knows that you are done defining your procedure and that it should carry on with the rest of the program. Is it all about the indentation?
Thanks for the question, Stormborn. We noticed in Python that the white space actually matters. And this is different from many languages. Those of you who have programmed in other languages like Java or JavaScript or C know that you have to have lots of syntax to tell the compiler where statements end and where blocks end and begin, where you have semicolons and you have squiggly brackets and you have other things in your code that are really there just to help the compiler know where things begin and end. In Python, white space is used for that. So the new lines matter, the indenting matters. And the Python interpreter knows when a block ends based on where the indenting is. That's really nice in the sense that it makes it easy to read your code. You don't have to worry about adding brackets and things. And if you look at someone else's code or you look at your own code, the structure of the code tells you what the code means because it has to have the same indenting structure as the blocks that are interpreted by the Python interpreter. This sometimes causes problems, and this is why many languages don't pay any attention to white space, that if you copy code between different editors or you change things that change the white space, well, in Python, that changes the meaning of your code. So you have to be careful that you don't change the indenting or don't change where the new line breaks are and things like that, because in Python, that can actually change the meaning of your code. But it is a handy way of making it clear to the interpreter, as well as to a human reading the code, the structure of the code, and it saves having to need any extra syntax like squiggly braces or semicolons to do that.